Well, I really like having my hair pulled, or I did, but I don't anymore. But a lot of people, basically the flesh that covers the top of the head is called the galea ponorotica. It's a helmet of flesh, right? It has the frontalis muscles in the front and the occipitalis muscles in the back that control it. And part of the thinking is that the bones of the skull need to be able to expand and contract microscopically with pulse and cerebrospinal fluid movement and things like that. And if your scalp is on too tight, then it holds you in place and locks you in. And so whether the theory is correct or not, people find a great deal of pleasure, some people, find a great deal of pleasure having their hair pulled. So if you put your hands in close to the roots and grab a big hunk of hair, lots of hair, and lean back with it, and you get the right amount of pressure, it feels very sedating to people, and it feels very pleasurable.
Thank you.
We do a lot of stretches, and the stretches are really important, but it's important not to overstretch people, and that means we don't move into the stretches too quickly, and we're happy with little gains rather than shooting for big gains. And the body responds best to small gains over time rather than big gains all at once. And so we're cognizant of that when we stretch people. They are where they are. There isn't any place that a muscle or limb is supposed to be. It's where it is that counts. So we work with what is. And that's really important. So preconceived ideas of human health and well-being don't serve us well. So we were doing a modified form of shiatsu. The namakoshi shiatsu, that was the original shiatsu, is very different. But shiatsu means finger pressure. And so we use our fingers and our thumbs and our elbows and our knees and our feet to stimulate our sedate meridians that course energy throughout the whole body and play a large role in health. But because we're Westerners, we've also added sort of Western science to this. And so what we're looking for is putting people into a deep state of relaxation, what's called parasympathetic dominance. And parasympathetic dominance means they can be alert, but their body is very, very relaxed. And they're in alpha state and a state of general relaxation. And that comes through sensory touch, stimulating the brain with our touch, and working the meridians and increasing energy flow in the body, which enhances health.